Okay, so let's go ahead and look closer on what tools we actually have, because this is primary elements we can work inside the flame painter. So first you'll notice it's a brush, and brush give us this ability to actually draw on our canvas. From brushes, we have all different type of a brush. We have flame, ribbon, flow, linear, elastic, and fuzz. And each of them, if you look on brushes preset as I'm change, you can see they will be modifying. They have different presets that we can use it. You can also create your own. As well, you always can click on get more, which is will take you to the web page. And right here you can see you can preview more of the particles. You can purchase or download it or share your own. And we'll look later how you can share your own or upload it. As a particles, if we look on a brush tool, click on a hamburger right here, you can see we have it options to use the global shape and the palette. We can check this or update only on the movements, which is little bit speed up your render. So we have it properties for the brushes as we selected. And also if you use it Vicom or other pad, you can extend and modifying some sensitivity on positioning on a smoothing gears. So I'm using mouse, I won't do that. Okay, in the particle system, right here we have already preset brushes. And again, don't worry if you don't find your brush preset. I said before, we will go later in a brush creator and we'll create our own brushes later on. But for now, we'll just let's look on what we have with the tools. And as a brush, we can start painting. When we start painting, you can notice it is elements going over. And based how we play painting will based on the size of our brush. We can create a very small one, size of our brush, or we can create extremely large. Also, right now, blending mode set to the normal. We can modify depending on what effect we wanted. Lighting will with add luminosity, and you can see it's creating kind of brighter. Let's actually reduce size a little bit. So you can see it's add on luminosity value. We also can go a little bit darker. So it's this way, it will going more with a subtraction. So it will go lighter, darker, or normal. We'll go back to normal. Also, we have an opacity. And if we want a less opacity, we can always create a bit more smoother. And with less opacity, the other modes will work much better. For example, if you can see lighter, so it's kind of add this dark glowing element. Same with the darken, so it will kind of create a little bit more intense and go in darker to the black shifting. So there are opacity, and we have it our lines wide. So we have it some few properties we can modify with the brushes. Again, there will some of this will change, and you can see additional properties. It's appear depend on what we're using. If we're using ribbon, we now have it lines count and width. If you remember before in the flame, we just have it only lines width. So next we have flow. Some elements we have right there. So we'll go to binary. And this is almost like classic brush. We can use it kind of brushing around. Notice as we're using this one, currently it says to using the our gradients that we currently have. Okay. Next, we'll go to, let's look at elastic. And as I'm changing this elastic, everything, our presets is also change depend on what type of particles, on what brush we're selecting. So and if we're going fuzzy, you can see right here, we also change on quite a bit on our fuzzy, so we can go around. This is overall, again, preview on some of this type of the brush we can use it. And we can create and adjust our own, and it's what we'll do later. So next, let's go and look on other tools that we have around here.